Shopify to QuickBooks Online integration apps, there are so many. How do you choose the right app? Hello, e-commerce entrepreneurs. I'm Veronica Masek, founder of Mavency, where we help Shopify sellers and their bookkeepers to set up, organize, and streamline their financial systems and bookkeeping. When you go into Shopify, you're probably seeing a long list of Shopify to QuickBooks Online integration apps. How do you choose the right one? And could choosing the wrong integration app mess up your books? Actually, it could. Let's take a look at two ways of integrating Shopify and QuickBooks Online. Number one, individual transactions. One approach is to integrate individual transactions into QuickBooks, such as sales receipts and invoices for every sale made. Most integration apps use this approach, but there's a problem. Let's say that you're making hundreds of sales a day or even hundreds of sales a month. You don't want all those individual transactions into your QuickBooks. It can lead to cluttered books and it will slow down the performance of your QuickBooks file. Another problem is that there's not a streamlined way of applying individual sales transactions to net amounts deposited by Shopify or your payment processors. That would be very time consuming and impractical. As a result, I don't recommend using apps that bring over individual transactions into your QuickBooks. Some of the apps that I will stay away from are QuickBooks Sync by Bold, QuickBooks Online, and QuickBooks Online Global. There are many other apps that sync individual transactions to QuickBooks, so be careful when choosing those apps. Number two, summarize transactions. Another approach to integrate Shopify and QuickBooks Online is to use apps that sync over summarized transactions to QuickBooks. These apps will summarize your sales, refunds, returns, shipping income, sales tax collected, and payouts by payment gateway. They will send those transactions to QuickBooks on either a daily, weekly, or monthly basis. There are two advantages to this approach. First, your books will not be cluttered by hundreds of individual transactions. And second, you will be able to reconcile your sales transactions to net amounts deposited to your bank account by Shopify and your other payment processors. You probably guessed that this is my preferred method for syncing Shopify transactions to QuickBooks Online. One of the apps that we use here at Mavency for integrating Shopify with QuickBooks is A2X. I will link that for you in the description below and share a discount code with you. Another app that you may look at is Bookkeep. They also send over summarized transactions to QuickBooks. And there are also other apps that will give you the ability to send either detailed transactions or summarized transactions to QuickBooks. Some of these apps include Cinder, Dext, and Webgility. Regardless of what you choose, make sure that you choose apps that send over summarized transactions to QuickBooks Online, and also make sure that they have a way to reconcile your payment processor deposits. For more resources on Shopify bookkeeping and financial management, check out my free Shopify bookkeeping blueprint. I've linked that for you in the description. Do you need help setting up your Shopify to QuickBooks Online integration? Then check the description below to learn about Mavency and whether we'd be a good fit for working together. Thanks for joining me today. Remember to like, subscribe, and hit that notification bell to stay up to date with all things e-commerce bookkeeping. Till next time, happy selling.